we should get a group and start killing all babies, and when they get us and arrest us, we will tell them our story, and then we are the true disciples of Jesus. We have died on the cross for these children, so they don't have to go to hell. So she was defeated, but they don't have an answer, but they don't accept it, and it makes no sense what you just said, that the baby goes to this place and goes to heaven. We'll just kill them then. So they're not interested because the mind is shut. They're not really looking for the truth. They're suffering. So they want some space with it. So time is up. Any questions? Any comments? One.
Mahamantra is our whole life. Please, Guru Kripa Prabhu. You have long experience in chanting japa, many years. I am wondering, is there some difference in chanting japa nowadays, when nowadays and let's say 30 years ago? Is there some difference in chanting japa?
Chanting correctly. Is that for me personally? Is there any difference for me now than 30 years ago?
Yes, I'm wondering.
Yeah. If the question is there any difference in the chanting japa now than 30 years ago? And actually, the answer would be is that you don't really chant. The non-prabhu, he appears and chants. He's doing it. You are making effort, he appears. So there's no effort. In other words, it is present. It's a living, it's a person. The holy name is a person. It's Krishna, directly Krishna. But there's no difference between Krishna and his name. He's absolute. So when one chants the mantra, it automatically manifests itself in chants. You're chanting it, Hare Krishna, but you're aware that he's there. You're totally aware, and you're totally not putting any force or trying to control your mind, because Krishna's attracting you. Your mind's not going here and there, it's just, you're there. And you just go on chanting the name. And gradually, you will see Krishna when you chant. That is what we're after. You will see Krishna appear before you. I've heard in Shastra, and I've also heard from those who have Prabhupada's godbrother, particularly Puri Maharaj, who told me. I asked him what it was like the first time you could see Krishna. And it's just like Narada Muni, as in Bhagavatam. He said, one day you will be doing your namam, and like that, Krishna will appear with a flash of lightning. He said, from that day you're different than everybody else. Because that purification goes to the core of the heart. Just like if you got hit with a lightning bolt. If one can understand or can give some mercy like that, then the purification is so potent that it covers millions of lives of contamination. We have been here, Anadi. There is no time. It's called immemorial. You cannot put a date when we got here. Since then, El Rupe Barmande Kona Bhagavanji, we've been wandering all over the universes. Sometimes a dog, sometimes a demigod, sometimes a king, sometimes a yogi, whatever. We're passing time. And according to the state of the mind at the time of death, when Yam Babi Smaran Balam, kids that are playing on you, we get that body, Antakale Smaran Deva, Smaran Mukhbhagavan. So that chanting is there, and as one goes on, it is up to Krishna to give mercy. And if one is concentrating and he is avoiding offenses, then it will become rapidly appearing. Our problem is we keep making the offenses, so we keep having to struggle because we love our offenses. Once you avoid the 10 offenses, then it will come.
Any other questions?
Arishma Bhavati. The statement which is still I am not clear. We are not a doer.
Huh?
We are not a doer.
Doer.
We're
not the doer.
Yes.
We are the chooser.
Yes.
You see, we are the chooser. Prakriti kriyamanani gunihi karmani sarvasya. The gunas are doing it. We are just choosing. You can choose to be under the mode of ignorance, just like if you choose to be under the mode of ignorance, it immediately takes effect. But it's your choice. Just like if you want to smoke some ganja. It's your choice. You made the choice. But once you smoke the ganja, then you're under the influence of the drug. You're not the doer at all. The drug is acting. You just chose. So we can always choose. You either choose this way or that way. You can choose to get up in the morning, or you can choose to stay in bed. You can go to Mangalarti or not. That's your freedom. Nobody's going to come knock on your door telling you you got to get up. But you tell me the difference, how you feel all day. You either feel happy and light, or you feel in the mode of ignorance because it's up too much. You just chose. And if you associate karanam guna, sangha asya, sarasat jama yomisha, you associate with the modes of nature, karanam guna sangha asya, you're associating with the modes. Sarasat yomisha. You meet with good or evil in that way, good or bad. So all we can do is choose. We have chosen to be under Krishna, or you can choose to be under Maya. Krishna Surya Samamaya Haya Antikar. Krishna is like the sun, Maya is like the darkness. Wherever there's sun, there can be no darkness. So the sun is there, but you can hide in a dark room. Up to you. You can expose yourself or not expose yourself. And if you don't, if you do, you get the benefit. If you don't, you get another result. So we have no independence. We have, our only independence is to choose. And then everything is acting under Krishna's arrangement. You understand that? Therefore, we are jiva. We are not the controller. We cannot control. The body is going on. You will get old. It is aging right now. It is digesting. It is doing everything. It is seeing how we are seeing. How we are smelling. Do we know? How we are hearing this. This is discussing. Are we in control of that? No. And a stroke comes along and you realize you're not in control of that. Immediately frozen. You lose all the ability of the senses to function. Are we in control of the time of death? No. So why do we think we're in control of the time of life? You cannot control your death, how you can control your life? You can only choose. And as you choose, then the result comes. You can choose to go to school, study, the result will be there. You may get some good job and some easy life. You may say, no, I'm going to go hang with the boys on the corner and drink cold 45. And then we'll see you in 5 years where you're at. We'll still be on the corner with a diseased liver and a burned out brain, and it didn't bring you any good result. So everything is choice. That's why we choose. There's so many varieties to choose from. You can choose to drink milk, or you can choose to drink cold 45. That's a beer. You can choose. One will develop your brain, and one will destroy it. It's only your choice. And once you do that choice, then you're under the influence of whatever that is. The milk will give you one mood, and that will give you another mood. So really, we have no independence. We only can choose. That is our independence. I hope you get that. If you don't, keep on checking. I'm Lewis from the Brown Lab. Thank you.
Try.